plan. A plan is when you have an idea and then you research and develop that plan. You do your P&Ls, you do all your projections. Am I making sense now? Yes. You figure out what it's going to take you. In other words, the Bible said, count up the cost. And when you count up the cost, it doesn't matter if you end up with more outgo than you do income. God, I just wrote the plan because that's what you gave me. Now God is going to bring it to pass. And God has a way of making nonsense plans come to pass and be successful. You have to be aware of distractions. Because the devil will dress up a good opportunity. He'll dress up a good opportunity. Sometimes it is the process of the long term that causes us to become so frustrated with the process, and the devil will dress up a short term.
Yeah, he will.
And we start to focus so much on this right now that we lose sight and we get off course of accomplishing the long term. Make sure I'm trying to become the man that God called me to become. Make sure I'm trying to become the woman that God called me to become, and not becoming a man pleaser.
Right.
What I become in the kingdom may not please you, but as long as it pleases God, that's all that matters. So what happens is, you can't get in to temporary moments of despair and frustration and fatigue. Some of y'all get in too quick. There are some things that we should have won. There are some accomplishments that should have been finished by now. There's some goals that should have been attained by now. But we gave in to temporary moments of despair and frustration. And in 2011, I have to make up in my mind, I don't care if my toe hurt, my head hurt, I'm tired, I've been at work all day. Whatever I have planned to accomplish, I'm not going to let the sun go down without that thing being complete. Let me tell you something. It's better to take a long time and finish it than to die with an incomplete.
Yes, sir.
I want you to understand something. I don't care where you work and who you work for. Somebody at some point is going to talk to you. Y'all say crazy. At some point,
somebody
is. And I want you to understand something. You're going to grow to a point where you're not going to be able to quit every job because you don't like the way things are going. Lion has their pride and dignity.
Yes,
Center Point has their pride and dignity.
They
and then with all their pride and dignity, come right onto your place and turn those services right on. And everybody keeps their dignity. There were some challenges that God allows to take place as an example for us to develop character. I would never develop patience if everything happens when I want it to happen.
All right.
You will never develop patience if everything happens when you want it to happen.
Right.
How you want it. You never need to.
That's right.
No. You never develop long suffering if you don't lose some battles.
That's right.
No. You never will. So you take these negative confrontations as an opportunity for God to develop you. Am I making sense tonight? In the natural, there is nothing more challenging than to live perfectly before the Lord. When you first come into the fold, and you sit there in the pew and you cry because the word is convicting, and I know I'm wrong, and I know God's been merciful, and I know God's gracious, and I had a whole lot of negative situations. I should have been dead, but I'm still here. So I walk down the aisle and I sit there, I'm crying, I'm giving my heart to God, Lord, give me another chance. And after all of that is over,
right?
Woo, Paul said there is a war in my belly. You must understand the fight begins. Until you close your eyes.
That's right, Pastor.
Only thing is, the fight continues. What happens is, as you mature, the weapons of the enemy changes.
Yes.
Right. You know, I'm saying, for a long time, you know, he don't use the same thing against you that he used against the young folk. He ain't gonna bother you with no stealing.
No.
He ain't gonna bother you with no cussing. See that?
No.
Stealing, cussing, backbiting, being messy, you know, fornication, lying, cheating. That's young folks stuff.
Yeah. Come on,
right? Am I right?
Okay, what do you want? What do you get us about?
But when you get up into the hierarchy of the kingdom,
uh-huh.
You get up in the hierarchy of the kingdom, you got other things uh-huh. like contention and rebellion. People that's been in church a long time, been saved a long time, and all begins to birth new folk in the church, and they start to take the position that you used to have. Fault finding. Am I making sense now? Cantankerous. I was sharing with some of my leaders on the other night. You know, sometimes you wonder why a person would be a member of the church. It's not everybody. But sometimes the person can be a member of church for a long time, and the church just going to hell in a handbasket, and they won't leave. They won't leave. Because when a person gets, what happens is, in most cases, when a person joins a church, and some of you young folk need to get that. Because for the most folk, the generation that passed, in most cases, unless something just really, really happened that was hindering their kingdom growth, when a person joins a church, am I right or wrong? Your intention is to be buried in that church.
Yes. All right.
Yes. Nobody joins a church thinking about, I'm going to leave.
Yes. Yes.
Except for the people that join the church and say, I'm just on assignment. Yes. And when people come and tell you, I'm just over here. And every time you ask them to help with something, I'm just on assignment. Well, we putting a group together, we want to organize the effort. Well, I'm just on assignment, you know, I'm just... And when folks say that, you already know.
Yeah,
you know, that's not even. But he said, he who is steadfast. And what I'm saying is, when people join churches, they really intend to be there for a long time. Now, details will come. Misunderstandings will come. Fights will come. If you fight with your biological family, you know you're going to fight with your church family. When you get through fighting and fussing and arguing, make up. And keep it moving. You don't want to be a church hopper in the kingdom. Every time your family comes for visit, you take them to a different church. That happened to the old church. I like that one. And then when you leave the church, you always got a whole bunch of negative stuff. Just don't say nothing about it. Just let it be what it is.
Amen.
And so what happens is, most people don't, if you don't have any consistency in your spiritual life, you won't have any in your natural life. When you work on a church. And sometimes you have to learn how to refuse to be interrupted by spontaneous people. And tonight you have to destroy this demon of sentiment that keeps you holding on to things and people that are broken. You have to identify people who become impediments to your destiny. And you have to dismiss them and get rid of them so you can expedite the process. It shouldn't take you 15 years to do something that can be done. The reason that it took Israel 40 years to take a 3-year journey was because of their disobedience to God. They were influenced by people who did not have a relationship with God and who refused to be consistent to his commandments.
Yeah.
And some of us mean to do well. Some of you mean to do well, but you're surrounded by the wrong people. You're never going to be consistent with God if all your close friends are casual worshipers. You have to find somebody that is as intense in their worship as you.
Wow.
When your friends are casual worshipers, they just kind of go in and now and then. You can't sit at home on Sunday and feel good about it. But you got friends, now let's go, ooh, let's go to them. They having a show. It is Sunday at 12 o'clock. Well, you know we had church. I'm going to go.
No.
What?
See, we got quiet.